of Heroes Live.
How is everyone? It's a Saturday night for me, and a random day of the week, probably for you. It's a 1v1 on Angoville, of course, Company of Heroes. On the north side of the map, we have someone that is so sparkly and shiny because they're just fresh out of the newbie factory. Wherever that newbie factory is, we've never seen him before on Inuki TV. It's BravoMyLife. I'm sure there's a sweet story behind that, but he has quadruple pioneers. Actually, that's just two squads, but there's four guys there. We're going single man this time around. And we got our Wehrmacht quarters up very, very fast. And these guys moving as a four-man elite cell. Look at that guy. He's waving his arms to the guys behind him. There's nobody there. Okay, maybe he has some imaginary friends. He's got some mental cuckoo problems. Anyway, we know this guy. Give a round of applause for Go Pepsi Live. No, we won't do that at all. Pepsi was featured in the last game as well. And he's got his barracks up, his rifleman team is already just about to be out. There we go. Wonderfully timed there by Lord Inuki, Lord of the Flies. I hate flies. Oh, they're so irritating. That's why I've not eaten today, but there's always a reason why I've not eaten today. In any case, we have some Volks out from above in my life. Now, I do want to go through the announcements again. We have our announcements. I'm a bit short on time. So there might be less multicam games, but there are two sort of like Company of Heroes titles that I have. I have the normal one, the Company of Heroes, whatever that is called. But then I have the Company of Heroes Live, which usually does not feature multicams. Now, if it's uploaded as a live version, it may not necessarily be live, but it is certainly not going to have multicams in it. We had some catwalking, by the way. Quite possibly from this guy. I'm not sure if it was actually successful because there were some engineers over here from Pepsi Live capturing. Ooh, interesting barbed wire going down for BravoMyLife. I like it. He doesn't need to do the whole place, but sure, why not? I'm sure some engineers will come along here shortly and some cutting action will be in act. Whatever accent that was, but Pepsi Live, very, very focused on this right-hand side. Bravo. Kind of digging a little adventure tunnel now with his Volks. He's going to encounter some riflemen though from Pepsi, and Pepsi seems to have a much better positioning here. He's going to move around into the front of the windows, which is an appalling idea. This is not good flanking tactics. He could have easily just fired at these two windows here with some light cover, and that'll be fine. But he's going to avoid combat. He doesn't want to fight any of these useless battles. He's going to take cover behind the tractor instead. Good old line combination. Still very little engagements happening. We now have engineers moving up to the victory point, and Bravo seeing that he is kind of out of position here, so he's going to move his Volks the front of the door and then back inside the house. Yay! Alright, it's musical chairs with only one chair, and the chair is a house. Now, these rifleman squads, they're just kind of giving sight at the moment all around here, which would be perfect time for an engineer to come out and cut that as this jeep comes out and gives them more sight. We've got Volks in a single sandbag here. These guys don't actually have a symbol up there, so maybe they're not getting the full benefit of the cover, but in any case, we've got this MG42 out finally. The critical piece of the Wehrmacht army. But that is being flanked by Pepsi's jeep. He's going to make that run around in circles. At least he's gonna... Oh, no, this might be it for the jeep. Oh, no, move, jeep. It's setting up in the wrong direction. Okay, we're fine. Fine. Stupid annoying trees in the way. Someone's getting the piss beaten out of them. It's quite possibly these cows. Failing that guess, it could be these guys. They destroyed the picket fence. Why would you ever do that? Flamethrowers have been upgraded. These engineers. Oh, he forgets about those pioneers. They're gone and out of there. We're getting the jeep repaired up from the engineer squad with the flamethrowers. And the riflemen are just being totally flanked. What is this? Black Hawk down. I don't see any helicopter which has fallen down here. So why were these guys so out of wacky positions? Yeesh. He just managed to run away at that, but these guys are not fighting efficient now. They've got to pull back all the way to base, heal up, reinforce. We don't even have a triage center down right now. We got bars coming out. Early bars. This could change the fight in favor of Pepsi Live, but I believe that he is massively outnumbered. It's not going to happen. You can see Pepsi live. He's trying to be smart about this, but it's not working out. He ran into negative cover there. He just wanted to get behind the bushes. Now these guys are slightly less movie. That guy in particular. Meanwhile, on the fuel, the engagement favorable in the hands of the Allies this time round. Trying to lock this Volk squad so he's unable to retreat back, but come on, a few more bullets from the rifleman. The Jeep is gonna be in hot pursuit. The flamethrower squad are in suppressed mode. That guy looks like he got a headshot with a flamethrower. No one does a headshot with a flamethrower, but it happened here on Inuki TV. And I think Pepsi Live may actually lose. He did actually lose that. Why would you ever sacrifice your flamethrower squad? The same happened to Bravo, though. Everyone's dying. Everybody's losing. Nobody. We could have been a bit faster here with the chase down with that Jeep. We did manage to get this cutoff point, by the way, so no munitions, and no fuel. That's a huge, massive decrease in income. And we've just got this Blade Man from Clinton, who is actually a Klingon, judging by his name. The Bars, though, seem to have done this pretty well. Bravo, dude. Okay, we get the picture, Clinton. You're a massive, spammy, hardcore guy. But he doesn't have the victory points in his favor. We only have one. One for everybody on the map. The Jeep darts around here. It's got a single kill. It manages to prevent the MG42 squad from capturing massive fuel. But in the meantime, somebody please go ahead and cut this. So anybody will be fine. But where are our engineers? Engineers have gone. They're all eradicated. They're out of the picture. So we'll go back to the only combat that we can see on the map right now is between triple Volks and double barred riflemen. One has some veterancy, but these guys are really beaten up. Like, they've just been put in a fat fryer and then battered and then eaten by a Scotsman. So little on health. He's going to get away, though, just on one minor bar of life. I'm not even sure he counts as human anymore with that amount of life. Our rifleman team on the right-hand side not coming in for a flank. They're going to stay on that negative cover road, not taking any fire. Yeah, there's the retreat from Pepsi Live. Okay, Clinton, we get it. Go away, Clinton. Oh, Bravo. He's so cool. He's like, K. I don't know why the double K appears. Can anyone give me the origin of the story behind double K? It's like someone said, K, dude, that's not being much of an asshole. We need, like, some way to be... Like, we're gonna put in effort to have a douche reply. Just to show that guy that we kinda don't like him. We don't appreciate what he's saying to him. K is like, ignore. But double K is like, I'm putting more effort in to ignore what you've said. You know that story. Our Jeep out of position as well. Pepsi, king of being out of position. Also king of triple spiral backflips off the wall loopy jump. Not too good for the health of the Jeep crew. Okay, right, we got our triage center down for Pepsi. What have we got up for Bravo? It's a tier 2. This is looking interesting. I've never seen the corner of this building before. We shall get a lovely, lovely close-up of that. Meanwhile, capturing the victory points because they are the goal, the objective of the game. MG42 on the left-hand side. It has some okay coverage of this point here. Ooh. And our Volk squad taking cover behind. I mean, this is the position that I wanted to see Pepsi in earlier. There are only two, that is two, one and two windows on the side of this building, and a whole gaggle of Volks grenadiers behind this wall. And a grenade even went in from the side from some grenadiers who are admiring the wreckage of the Jeep which died a few moments ago. And the bar rifleman actually doing pretty well because we have reinforcements off screen. And now they'll be able to capture that victory point, which means they'll be up by two victory points, and the clock continues ticking down. Now, this is not a GG for Bravo just yet. I don't know why Clinton the Klingon decided to say that, but I'm sure he's watching the stream right now going, maybe I made an incorrect call. We have minesweepers down for Pepsi Live. I've not seen any mines destroyed or built just yet. None have gone off. None have been... Oh, we got some mines down. We've got infantry division picked by Pepsi Live. You can see he's putting mines down with his squad. I'm probably going to see that this guy put some mines down. Now we're going to go for a straight-up retreat and get some life back on these dudes. Because they're at 50% life right now. And we have enough time to retreat back and get back into the middle of the field. Better to do that than to lose, like, too much and then unable to defend it in time. What I mean is, if they retreat them now, you'll heal up faster, and then they'll probably meet around about this area when they fight. Interesting observation post going down. I'm glad I caught that. That's going to make a world of difference, either going for a fast motor pool and a fast MA, or possibly going straight up to a tank depot, which could be kind of painful for Bravo if he doesn't see that. But he has seen that the fuel is out, so he's probably going to get some packs out sharpish, most likely. No stickies. Definitely no stickies for Pepsi. He has just narrowly avoided the telephone pole. It's being nudged. He's crawling under it. That training. Ooh, he knew that training would come in handy, crawling under those wooden posts. And now we have a perfect flank from Pepsi Live coming right behind the Volk squad with his Vet 1 strong squads. There we go. We're back in the commentary. Our half track, though, is not going to take too much damage from the bars, but it will take some. Any damage is some damage, but Half-Track was actually managing to suppress that squad there. It takes some time, a lot of time. There's the stickies up just in time. And now Bravo is regretting staying around as the damage engine kicks in, and maybe the second squad will be able to put off a sticky. The bars do secondary damage on that engine. Going to be moving even more slower. Meanwhile, on that left-hand side, we have Pepsi engaging a Grenadier squad. He is losing that one. Four guys lost there. Almost one more as well. Who is this guy? What was he doing there? He's kind of having some gut pains right now. Maybe passing a kidney stone. And you can see... Wow! We actually lost that half track. That's actually pretty darn good from Pepsi Live. That's a huge loss there for Bravo. No longer going to be able to reinforce in the middle. Not going to even going to see one of those walking Stukas later on in the game if that half track decided to survive till that moment. But to be fair, we are not going to see a tier 4 from the Wehrmacht anytime soon. He's going to want a reasonable reaction, a reasonable response to this observation post. I just heard a mine explode. Of course, it's in the middle. One lone survivor with a flame canister. Just one flame canister? I think he's lost one of the flame canisters. I'm sure they meant to have two. In any case, lots of Volks coming here, putting a load of lead into this observation post. Rangers have been brought into the battlefield. Hello, you guys. Instantly with Thompsons as well. And I like this call. Because at the moment, it's mainly Volks on the field, and Thompson are going to rip them apart. And if they can get some veterancy off that, I know Volks give very little XP. But any XP they can get, free XP indeed. They'll do... What is this guy holding a Panzerschreck weirdly? He's got a Panzerschreck... He's been augmented with a Panzerschreck arm! Careful! The Wehrmacht army are using augmentations to enhance the soldier's ability. Maybe they have bionic eyes. Oh, they could happen. Probably not that, though. But something like that, I don't know. Occasionally, now again, you'll see some visual bugs with Company of Heroes. As with every game, actually. I'm loving this line of soldiers. This is how you move in a battlefield. I've seen Pepsi Live. He might trail off later on the game. As an analysis, I've seen a lot of Pepsi Live. Oh, he's even destroying that. Such a great move. He doesn't want Bravo to salvage any munitions from that. But as I was saying about Pepsi Live, I've seen a lot of games of him. He seems to have good spacing out early on in the game. But later on, when stuff like Propaganda War might hurt him, when he just instantly blobbed up retreat or artillery, he tends to blob up his infantry, and it kind of really hurts. It's very painful to watch a player of this caliber just get destroyed in one attack, just a mass retreat. RMG-42 in a wonderful, delightful position. Our Grenadier squad hitting some mines, and there comes the retreat. But they are retreating in enemy territory. I mean, they kind of have it, but interestingly enough, we got some... Ooh, I did not see this go down. Even mines protecting its flank as well, just in case that happens. Brain, come on, brain. Maximum capacity. I know this is an exciting game, but there's no time to stop calling out this beautiful flank that's happening from Pepsi Live. It's only a double-way, two-way flank, though, but the MG-42, a grenade goes down on it from the Rangers. and only one guy left. If we can just pick apart that, another second grenade goes. It's a fail of a grenade though, and our Volks are coming round at a decent angle to hit these guys up close. Now another grenade comes off here. I think that guy, oh no. Now let's just do a quick body count here on the ground. I'm seeing one there, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. At least nine German soldiers dead there. I can only see maybe four, possibly five allies there. So definitely an engagement favorable to the allies. He's going to retreat, he's going to regroup there. And again, I imagine that the Germans are only going to be able to get to here before the allies. Pepsi can come back, and look at this medic. Wow. Oh, he got there and he disappeared. Oh, that's got to be irritating. How annoying. I'm sure he's going back to base to be sexually frustrated. And our riflemen are now moving over to the left-hand side to support the engineer squad. And our rifleman squad inside the building here. This is just a pure delay. So anytime they can buy here, oh, the flamethrower, perfect, absolutely delightful to see this from Bravo, burning Pepsi live inside that building. These guys hop out, and yeah, rightfully need to retreat now, but we are almost, oh, a sniper, so we do have a weapon support center out. I guess what Pepsi live has done here is very, very psychological. He knew, I mean, we got a decent amount of fuel from that, that did die, but we could have possibly went for a motor pool and a fast M8. Instead, what Pepsi did actually was maybe try and convince Bravo that he was going to go for a motor pool, and then just went back to a tier 2, and now he's going to own some more infantry. That's basically it. So Bravo isn't going to go for a fast tier 3. He already got a tier 2. That's noteworthy. But no fast tier 4 either, so he's not going to even bother with that. He's not in the know yet of this sniper on the field. So a lot of time to be bought here. Oh, mines, allied mines, absolutely everywhere. Will this sniper reveal itself anytime soon against this MG42? Yes, it will do. So now Bravo should actually click here and say, okay. Okay, I don't need to get a pack out. But he's already got a pack out, so never mind. And there we go. There's the Sturm Armory down. I'm liking it. It's a good call. We can get some Stugs out just in case we see a motor pool coming out. But a lot of time has been bought for this sniper to be effective on the field. Did that sniper just hit a mine? That sniper just hit a mine. Damn it! All that time we had bought for that sniper to be effective on the field has gone. I mean, face it, there's only going to be the Pumas and stuff like that. Maybe an enemy sniper as well, but from the tier 3, Nebel's officer? Could see an officer. Never an officer. New recruits in. We're back to man. That sniper. Such a waste. Now, we really need to start considering our tier 3 fast, and it's not happening. Rangers should be okay against a Puma, by the way. That's not going to be too much of a problem, but when Stugs start hitting the field and they get the MG42 Vet 2 upgrade, then that's going to be a huge problem. Without AT guns to deal with that, we're just going to have these free freaking Stugs with MG42s on them, and they can do whatever the hell they want until the motor pool comes up and gets some actual decent anti-tank counters. The Rangers are just not good enough. Pretty good against light armor, not too good against heavy armor, or medium armor for that case. We're about to see some mine action hitting. Come on. No, Volks, move back. It's going to happen. There we go. Oh, four guys in a tree. Five guys in a tree. And a propaganda war. So we know that Terra is in act. Four Bravo. We're seeing a retreating squad here as well. These guys are trying desperately to space out as much as possible so they can get around that MG, but that retreats because the left-hand flank from Pepsi live with the rifleman squad with 15 kills. Rangers trying to do the solo job on the left-hand side against two grenadiers and an MG42. I'm liking the MG42 position there. It's working. And we have a Puma. That was a reasonable assumption to come out from Bravo. The Rangers, though, if they can be in the right place at the right time, they shall thwart that armored car, and it shall not be able to do much damage. Instead, it's going to be a bad choice, but For now, it's okay because the Rangers aren't here. And it is being microed as well. The micro is a huge part for the Puma to play as. We are going for the cutoff point. We are actually going to get this cutoff point as well. And that straight away just retreat as soon as that comes out. We're not going to take too much damage from this. We're just going to delay some of the resources for a tiny bit. I don't think that was a good choice from Bravo, by the way. He's better off trying to win some of these battles rather than delay. He runs across a mine and detonates it. Two Pumas out. Okay, this is... Like, one Puma was... I'm not too sure about that, but two Pumas. It's a weird StarCraft logic, this is. And I can see a bunker going up in the background, but one Ranger squad was okay against a Puma. And I think they hit go mine as they went out. But one Ranger squad was okay against a Puma. We could have done that. But now that two Pumas have come out, that's going to seriously hard counter a Ranger squad. They can just charge in that and destroy it. And a wonderful propaganda war on the sniper and the Ranger squad there. The Ranger was the only guys that can destroy that bunker. But we could have brought our Pumas around here and countered that anyway. Lots of mines here. We really need to see a minesweeper squad from Pioneers. But unfortunately, that is not the option we have gone for on that Pioneer squad. We need to build a second Pioneer squad to do that. Do we have a motor pool going up? No motor pool. No motor pool. Motor pool, where are you? I choose you, Motorpool, Pepsi, you know this, you see that there are two Pumas on the field. It pains me, really pains me. Maybe he's just going to go all in with Rangers. He is getting the tank depot. Okay, but it's going to take us some time to get the fuel to get a tank destroyer. I think a tank destroyer would be the best option here as long as we avoid this pack, but Pepsi doesn't know that the pack exists right now. That hasn't fired a single squiddly jack of a shot. And we'll just sort of progress with infantry. Capping with the sniper. Pepsi. Don't do that, Pepsi. Don't do that at all, Pepsi. Our Pumas, our double Pumas, are here and raring to kill some riflemen. And they are charging in. I think they are going to try and get some stickers on that. They looked like they were, for a moment there, they were going to cap that victory point. But nay, that is not what's going to happen. They are going to get in as close. And I think there it is. They are close enough. Come on, throw that sticky. This squad, throw that sticky. Oh, not going to happen. Again, the micro is very, very important. And Lord into a perfectly positioned MG from Bravo. Round of applause for him. We have Rangers inside the building. These Pumas could actually triple Pumas now. Oh, it is really stacking against them. And we need some more fuel just to get a tank destroyer. That would annihilate all this. We'll be fine. We can see that the medical kits are being used. I just want to take a breather. A high-action game again. Who is this guy? Who is Bravo? My life! Why has he chosen that name? A sniper just picked apart. This is the second sniper to hit the field, by the way. I think we're going to see a grenade inside the building. There was one. Are we going to see a two? No! No, we are not. Now, the rifleman squad will retreat. Our sniper needs to do the same thing, and our ranger also needs to get the hell out of there. I think we might be banking for a Sherman. Interesting Volks position back here, by the way, and mines have gone off in the right center of the map. Pumas just etching forward. They could be a lot more ballsy. They could literally just go in the base and find out what's going on right now. Too scared of an AT gun, though, I presume. There's no reason to be scared of an AT gun. There is reason to be scared of all these mines, though, and that is what's doing it for Pepsi right now. And I think this mine actually might be triggered. If they want to go forward, the Vet 2, double Vet 2 rifleman squads are charging. They do have the increased sticky range, and look at that. That just glides so smooth through the air. And it doesn't actually destroy the Puma. Interesting. Now, we did have something purchased. It is just going to be a normal tank destroyer, M10, coming out here. So that should be able to goo the cleanup crew, do the cleanup process of these Pumas. We have mines down on the victory point, but Bravo, I'm liking it. Here comes the repairs as well. So that is a repair bunker, by the way. Very, very nice choice. Off-map combat group as well. We can get that out, and that would be superb if we can get some tanks and AT guns out of there. That is exactly what we need. We have the infantry. The attrition that Pepsi has done is done so far so good. I think we've lost a single rifleman squad and two engineers. A sniper as well. He's got some mines down here. That is good. That's good. Yeah, we have no minesweepers out just yet for Bravo My Life. We could certainly do that with the arsenal. Here comes the M10 tank destroyer. Oh, the barbed wire. The courageous barbed wire in enemy territory. Okay, yeah, fair enough. It is in the territory controlled by Bravo. But it is... grenades! I like grenades. Those were some wonderful grenades. But this area is on Pepsi's side of the map. So that's the point of view that I was going for. The M10 just kind of sits here at the front and says, "Hey, I'm over here. Can you see me? Pumas, beware. My presence be known." Keep stuff in the element of surprise as much as possible. That is when your opponents will make a mistake. Now, we have a medic. I think this might give a grenadier squad. No logic based upon this. I'm just pure gambling the fact that might happen. Here comes the M10 on the right-hand side, but quickly, medic. Am I right? It's a 1 in... No, oh, I'm wrong. It was a 1 in 4 chance, but... Ow, M10 blows apart one of the rear gunners of that MG42. The second shot misses, though. The sniper should be able to pick up the pieces. Here it comes! Ah, sniper. Ah, you dashed my hopes. An off-map combat group brings in a second M10. Our 30 cal gets wiped out. That survived no longer than 10 seconds. Not so cool at all. Pepsi Live, though, charging in with his newborn rifleman squad, which comes out from literally nowhere. An RM10, which is almost entirely destroyed as well. Three Pumas. Bet two on them as well. The M10s are going to do a lot of damage, but whether they can actually do enough damage before they get destroyed by this Pack 38, I don't know. I believe the M10 might have seen that. I mean, these don't have incredible amounts of range. No, he's definitely not seen that if he's not moving now. Here comes the Pack 38 fire. The Vet 2 Rifleman squad have got to get out of there. They are just going to make it, though. Just going to make it. That's good. That's nice. And our sniper coming back as well, going over to the left-hand side of the map. We have remanned the 30 cal, and we're just going to leave it in a defensive position for now. Okay, that's fine. No reason not to do that, because allies hate micro-wing MGs. Ooh, they absolutely detest the idea of having to move around a goddamn 30 cal, because it's no MG42. And we like our MG42s. They're dangerous. They need a freaking label on it that says, "Do not approach me," unless it's from the rear. They're kind of like tigers, or is it from the front? I can't remember. Very important to remember that fact, though. A mortar is here as well, so we got that from the off-map combat group. That could very well fire on the bunker there. Just constantly putting pressure on, light damage, and then our M10s can sweep around the side and destroy it. I heard another mine go off. Mine! Oh, I hate missing mines. It should really be on alert when you press spacebar. I'd kind of like that. Very useful information there. Now our M10s. Okay. There comes the repairs. Bravo My Life, ha ha ha, you suck, Puma Spammer. Clenton, you were cheering for him earlier on, and now you've turned against him? That's not the Klingon way, is it? I don't know, I've never watched Star Trek. I think I've seen a few episodes of Star Trek randomly on my TV, because the way my TV works is... not if I like the show, it's more if I don't like the show, if you can understand that. Yep, I'm super noob. Bravo. No, you're doing pretty well. I think the three Pumas is very good, but you didn't be aggressive enough. You had so much opportunity to run in there and destroy all the counters to your Pumas, and then all you had to do is just mop up the rifleman. There was so much room to do a lot of damage, and you didn't do it. Now, I admire cautious play, but sometimes your cautious play is going to backfire. Now these Pumas, what the hell are these? What the who? Where? I believe this is an ambitious plan which has a high opportunity to fail, but he's going to take it anyway because he's not a super noob. Not a super noob. He's just an opportunist and delusional. Highly delusional. But more of an opportunist than delusional, let's say. So we're not going the overly negative. Now, Sniper, if he decides to go capture this... Oh, here it comes! No, Pepsi Live! You didn't seize the opportunity to box your opponent in with a bullet to the brain! And now you've lost a rifleman squad. Too right, your forces are taking casualty. Our Panzer Shrek team are trying desperately to capture this munitions point. For what reason, I don't know. They're going to take extra damage, but nothing's firing at them. So fair enough, apart from the M10, which could swing around and turn that. There's a King Tiger on the field. This is a meat cleaver on tracks. Why would this be needed? We don't need... This was uncalled for. Bravo. I thought this was going to be a fair game, and you decide to bring this... It's just this. There's no words which can describe a King Tiger, really. I mean, it's essentially a giant box with tracks that says, "You over there, you are going to die," and then he dies. And I don't know. The King Tiger, you can only have one per game, and it's certainly you don't always need it. I don't think this King Tiger is at all needed in this fight at all. There were two measly M10s to take care of, and I think a pack and some grenadiers with Panzer Shreks would have been enough to do that. He's really trying to protect his Pumas. I think he kind of panicked there, saying, "I want someone to stop these M10s from killing my Pumas," when really, the Pumas can keep alive against the M10s. They're faster, they don't need to get themselves into awkward positions where the M10s can come around and flank. If they're surrounded by things like Pack 38s, and the grenadiers. Oh, a howitzer shot beautifully placed on the 38. But damn, it even destroys it as well. Some damage inflicted upon one of the Pumas. There it is, that Puma there. Our M10s come darting in, and where is that King Tiger? The King Tiger is just going to be too slow to assist the Pumas. What the Pumas should be doing is going to the King Tiger. Lure that M10 in there. That's the best we can do. And you can see this is the mistake now. The King Tiger cannot protect these fast tanks. It can barely turn. I wish there was a "Your mama is so fat" joke in here, but I'm not going to go there. And one of the pioneers decides to suicide him. He face rolls off the tracks. And look at this. Come on, King Tiger, King Tiger. Ah, this is what we need to protect us. Oh, my stomach is hurting, and not as much as those guys with the howitzer shot, the second howitzer shot of the game. The M10s and the Greyhound, I'm presuming this was from the off-map combat group earlier. One of the new ones, the second one on the field. Our Pumas are getting away. What did I tell you? All Pumas, two of the Pumas actually, one of them is alright, not too bad. Oh, my brain can't keep up with this amount of action. Our Sniper, what are you doing? 6 kills so far, close range shot on the Rangers. Are you going to take it? The Rangers are going to... Yeah, the Rangers do get it! They do get it, and straight away retreat. The M10 plows into the building, and one of the guys snowboards off with his face. Oh my god. Right, on the left-hand side, we've got capturing of territories all over the place now. To right, somebody's in the shit. The Greyhound's got to get out of there. Here comes the finger of death! And it actually just got absorbed by the Greyhound. We had a graphical error there. Representational of the situation that was realism? Nil, did not happen. I mean, it looked like it should have destroyed it, but it didn't. It just went into the middle and sort of exploded. Is that... Yeah, that's a Greyhound. That Greyhound's just going to try and fight it. There's no way the Greyhound can fight this because of that Panzer Shrek there. I mean, they could micro round there. But the Volk Squad is there as well, so they could indeed fire a Panzer Faustin! The Greyhound's so out of position now, the engineer's desperately trying to run there to repair it. I think the second shot is about to fire, here it comes! Wow, he missed, he aimed for the building. Howitzer shot onto the King Tiger. No, never do that, never ever do that. It's a bad idea, the thing is way too armored for a simple 150mm shells, I think it is. I'm pretty sure it's 150mm shells from the off. I don't know, it could be any imaginary number off the top of my head. But those shells are not going to penetrate that King Tiger. The guy's going to be shook up. And again, you can see the blobbing is in action. Double squads have been propaganda ward. I'm liking the position of the mortar. Two mortars, in fact. The grenade goes through the wall. The King Tiger could indeed just crush this wall. I think he would be in his best interest to do that. And reveal the position of the mortar crews to any infantry here. The King Tiger trying to kill the Ranger squad. That is the best target for the King Tiger right now. And the turret is a little slow to move. Of course, close quarters. This King Tiger seems to miss a tremendous amount. Here comes the Pumas, though, to reinforce. Back on mostly full health. 16 kills to one of the Pumas. 5 building kills for the other Puma. Go that. I guess it ran over some of the mines. Mines, counters, building kills, I don't know. I don't recall seeing any barbed wire or sandbags. From our allied player, Pepsi Live. Double sticky grenades on the King Tiger. Slowed engine. But do we have an AT gun to capitalize on it? Yes, we do. It's not far enough. Get that up there. Don't worry, we've got mortar crews protecting it. I wonder what the mortars are targeting. I think they are going to be targeting the King Tiger. If we could only immobilize this. Now, these rifleman squads, they're getting hit by the Pumas. Not anymore, though. Okay. They're getting out of there. That's it. High action over. I can slurp a derp some of the worky work orange juice. Really? Front shifted? I wouldn't have known. Capturing on the left-hand side, but these Pumas could just kind of go in, nitpick a little bit. You know, they only need to fire a few shots back out. What Bravo could be doing right now, I don't see too much. I mean, he's doing okay on the left. He seems to have mass retreated. I think that might have been a misclick, though. We still have the bunker up here as well. Greyhound. I'm liking this utilization of the Greyhound on the left-hand side. Kill off the medic. Kill off the medic. The medic. Kill him. There we go. Oh, nice and good. Oh, he's got that armor-penetrating back shell. I don't know why that is. Our Puma's receiving repairs from the Reparo bunker. In the meantime, the King Tiger slowly gets away and lures the rifleman squad inside of the MG42 fire. Now, I do see smoke shells coming down, and what those smoke shells need to be firing at is over here! This location here. Sniper, yes, perfect. Come on! Line that side up! I guess he's got priorities. I don't know what the priorities are, though. He's Vet 2 currently with 12 kills. Good job him. He could have got 13 kills if he decided to fire at the correct target! Or any target, for that matter. I mean, there's no dangers around here. I don't see an enemy sniper that could possibly thwart him. He is firing at that MG right now. I guess we've got to be looking out for the Pumas if they decide to dart past all of these potential stickies. I mean, no right logical person would do that. No one would run past or drive past a rifleman squad to get to a sniper. Not going to happen. There's no need to do that. No, I got hiccups now. It's not fair. Our Rangers are charging in with 19 kills. They're going to rack themselves up some more. Now, the King Tiger is no way going to actually escape here. But will a sticky grenade go off? We need to run as close as possible before we decide to throw this. Otherwise, that will happen. He keeps throwing it, moving forward, throwing it, moving forward. Come on, move forward enough here. Get here, get here. Ah, there we go, there we go. Will it immobilize? That is the question. But no, no, because it's on front. Now our Pumas are receiving repairs all the way back there. Pepsi Live still being very, very aggressive, though. He's got his M10 and AT gun moved really far up into enemy territory, and he is over the population cap as well. So he's in a pretty good position here as well with the Rangers on the left-hand side. Some of these Pumas could move up and take some shots inside of here. They should be okay at maximum range. The bazookas are not going to do enough damage, rather, to that. Our AT gun is firing at the King Tiger. Does Bravo see it, though? Something's happening on the rear. We have a Volk squad returning to base. They've just decided to retreat. And our M10, you know, whatever was there, he saw something. He saw something. There was something definitely there. Or was he never there to begin with? Our Pumas are receiving fire from the M10 now, but we're backing away. Both players. Oh, flamethrower! Oh, he's getting out of there. He's getting out of there. And the Flogs appear on the flank now. And at this crater here, which has been created, there's a pun in there somewhere. Definitely a pun in there somewhere. And is that a Neville, I believe? Double AT guns, however. If we can get ourselves into a good position for some side shots on that King Tiger, we may very well destroy it. Still damaged engine. It's going to take a while to rotate to the right and then drive away. So we got all the time in the world, reasonably, if we can move our AT guns up. One is firing from front. Armor penetrating shells as well. That would be awesome. You can see the sniper is also spotting for these AT guns as well. That is mint awesome. I like it so much. He's backing away now, though. And lots of repairs. That is how Bravo is going to fight this right now. He's got repair attrition up. But Pepsi's got all of the units he needs. Oh, excuse my back. I've been sitting down for so long. He's got all of the units he needs to really defeat this. Veterancy going up for the rifleman squad inside of the house. The Pumas, that's right, get in a nice position away from the AT guns. No, not from the front. Oh, he just gets behind that just in time, and one of the AT guns get... Oh, okay, what is this coming down? One of the mines is detonated by the M10, a firestorm. Not hitting the... No, the anti-tanker is running into the fire. Why would you run into the flames? Flames is bad. They're so cold. So cold the flames are. M10 is destroyed. It gets sandwiched. It even gets blocked by its own AT gun. Everything is just going to shambles for Pepsi Live. Why would he do this? The Greyhound is here to pick up the pieces, though. Hero Greyhound against the Pumas. Unfortunately, not going to take out the Panzerschrecks on the Grenadiers, though. Also Panzerfaust as well, presuming that Bravo has enough munitions to do that. I mean, it's not half bad to actually use your munitions against a Greyhound, but only when it's kind of low health and you're guaranteed going to kill it. Otherwise, it's just going to repair up, and it's a waste of munitions, and you feel disheartened and depressed, and you sigh a lot, and you're like, oh, I could have killed that 5 minutes ago if only I wasn't so stupid. I could have destroyed it there and then. And it's nice to hear that there is calmness. Wonderful, delightful. I can have a breather. We have an objective secure. I think we also have a mine, which is about to be triggered. Ooh, everyone survives, though. And the medics, wonderfully carrying some soldiers, the wounded to the left-hand side. But Pepsi sees it. He destroys him through the hay. And maybe this medic can pick up that medic to pick up that medic to go into the bunker now. More bunkers, by the way. More repairing. I guess that's the best thing you can ever do if you are population capped and you will have a lot of manpower. Get some bunkers down. Bunkers don't cost any population cap, so we can just plonk them down willy-nilly to secure areas. And now one of the medic bunkers have been destroyed. I think that's the only medic bunker, actually. Neville fired here and didn't actually do too much. It suppressed a single rifleman squad. I think they might be able to escape that suppression long enough. Come on, get back up. And Rangers get in front and lead the charge. These guys get back here. Now, I really want to see some sandbags and barbed wire from Rifleman. Yeah, from the Rifleman, from Pepsi Live. But I guess he's just kind of forgotten about that so far. Destroying the trees with his bazookas. Okay. Greyhound is going to pick apart the MG whilst the Rifleman and the Rangers do the rest of the work. Second Greyhound on the field. This is another off-map combat group. And it is doing the really lame damage. Wow, come on, you guys. We have the stolen AT gun, by the way, firing on the Greyhounds. The gunner has been killed. He flops out. He's like, That gunner literally never does anything. He's the laziest guy in the world. He pretty much gets the medal. Like the Purple Heart and laziness. I'm sure there's not a medal for laziness, but... Hey! I never went to military school. I wouldn't know. We are claiming some mortars. Interesting position of the mortars. I think these are Allied mortars as well, so... Like, why were they there? Pepsi? Maybe I mean, hair would be nice and safe and cuddly and soft and warm and moist, but in front of the bushes? You're gonna get killed there. It's a no-brainer. Really, really no-brainer. And now, Riflemen now. They want to play with some pumas. Some pumas, but puma sounds more dirty than puma, so we're gonna call it puma. I know some people hate that. Oh, they really hate it. Oh, we have some smokes up. Oh, what are the Riflemen gonna do? They're gonna try and finish off the dead puma. And prop war. Prop war, prop war, prop war. We gotta remember that, Pepsi. We gotta remember that. This has happened too many times already. And what is this? It looked like a friendly fire nebble there. He prop warred and then said, crap, I better nebble it. I better nebble the ground that they stand on. I don't want any allied influence. Those boot prints will convert me. Our Greyhound comes right behind the King Tiger. I think it's going to take some sluggy shots. Oh, it's going to lay a mine. Wow. Oh, will it get out of that? Where's the King Tiger? You know, there's Lazy Gunner again. But, oh, is that really going to do it? Someone's got to hit this mine, man. I think maybe this engineer squad. Oh, brill. I like that. I'm glad I stuck around for that. It was worth it. We got salvaging going off. And, we see the mines. The mines are not going to be detonated. The King Tiger almost blew it up, though. You can actually shoot the mines and they'll blow up. And you can then destroy any units on top of it, whether friendly or enemy. We lost an M10 on retreat. This looks like it was trying to get away. Did a pretty bad job of that, though. The Volks managed to score the kill there. 14 kills on this Volks. 10 kills on the Volks. 1 infantry kill. 21 infantry kills on the King Tiger. Ooh, this is a long game. We are 46 minutes in, by the way. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and help grow the channel of Inuki TV. And again, I'll apologize if I can't get as many games up with the multicam. I'll try and do as many as possible, but my time is just being depleter on Trond right now. I want to do so much, but there's not enough time. Here's the blob from Pepsi again. He's growing weak. His aura is fading. His ki is diminishing. His chakra is fucking gone. Put it at that. A nice grenade, but not so nice. It didn't actually kill as many rangers as you would. You'd think the grenades do, which is usually what happens when the veteran C starts stacking up. Oh, the beautiful smoke. I'm loving it. Double smokes landing on top of the soldiers' heads as these guys try and charge in. Are they going to get a sticky off? Sticky, 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 sticky. Why? I bet he's forgotten about this mine as well. And this could really hurt if he decides to retreat here. Or even a prop war. A prop war would send him into this mine. No longer, no. He would retreat down this road probably now. Sniper revealed itself. He's got 22 kills, vet free as well. Almost killed a Volk squad though. Ooh, we're going round. We're going to kill the repair engineers. We got another medic station up on the far left-hand side of the map. And we are, I think, we want to reclaim stolen property. We want our AT gun back, please. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Really fast dying on there. And now Greyhound is here as well. That's going to be useful somewhat. It does very minimal damage, though. Here comes our King Tiger on the left-hand side. It takes some time. That just friendly fire. I believe it. But I can never remember, like, 0.5 milliseconds behind. I guess you guys can replay it back, though. Here comes a sticky. 30 kills on this Rifleman squad. What are the Rangers doing so far? 27. The Pumas are going around the left-hand side, picking apart whatever they can. And I see that we have now 3 vet-free squads. And we could potentially lose them all here. Everyone's going to retreat. Everyone. That's good. I like this. Play it safe, Pepsi. Play it safe, man. You want to keep your vet squads up. We have 2 Greyhounds in the back here. They could... Oh, we lost our sniper. We lost the sniper. The Allied sniper is down. Our Greyhounds could take the Pumas, but not the King Tiger. Maybe we can see some twin Greyhound versus King Tiger action. Oh, I really want to see that. I really want to see that happen. Box it in, and then double mine it from both sides. It's not going to be able to rotate fast enough. Unfortunately, in the process, you'll probably lose your greyhounds, but you'll gain many, many fans on Inuki TV. So, hey, Inuki TV fans are pretty important, I believe. I noticed that some people try and insult me. It's not going to work, by the way. It's really not going to work, you guys. And it's not just me, it's pretty much any YouTuber. Literally any YouTuber will always have some Negatron try and ruin it for everybody. And I'm like, no, you can't insult me. I make music, I draw, I have a reasonable amount of talent, better than you who waste your time trying to insult people in comments. You're not going to insult me. It's not going to happen. But it's not you guys, because you are watching 50 minutes into the game. So, you are my hardcore fans. And you're gonna see some Greyhound action! Well, they're gonna die again. Mortars. Panzer Shrek on a Rifleman squad, bet free. This is, oh no, be hard hitting if they can get behind. Again, we are too close together. We need more spacing. This Rifleman squad might actually get themselves killed if they decide to run in front of the King Tiger. There we go. Damaged engine. And... run. The Panzer Shrek. Must save the Panzer Shrek. Screw the other five guys. double engineers on the left-hand side. One with a minesweeper. They're going to plop themselves here. The victory points as currently 85 to the Allies, 165. So doing well, Bravo, so far. He's still got this AT gun on the right-hand side as well, but Bravo is now focusing pretty heavily on the left-hand side of the map. He is using these Pureness to come up here and destroy an engineer squad, and here comes the Greyhounds in response. I'm liking this. And what will be the response to the Greyhounds? It will be the King Tigers. The King Tigers. Just the one, actually. It's not going to multiply or duplicate. We have the Grenadiers with the Panzer Shrek coming as well. And those Greyhounds are not in condition. Ooh. Listen to the screams. You can feel the pain. But many body parts are going to have to be reattached there if he wants to be back alive. Probably going to have a time machine if he wants to actually be alive there. Nothing's going to bring him back. Our Vet-free squads are being eaten alive, though. How is that happening? I guess it's got something to do with the Puma back here. And capturing under fire from two Grenadier squads as well, who also have Vet-free up. Not so good. And still no Tier 4. I think Bravo is just going to live with the fact that he has enough to defeat his opponent from Tier 3. Again, just... so out of position here. We got a howitzer strike coming down. Will we get lucky? Yes, we will get lucky on the first shot. Will we get lucky on the second shot? Yes, we will get lucky on the second shot. Will we get lucky on the third shot? No, we will not get lucky on the third shot, but the fourth shot is incoming and it will not finish off that Puma. But one Puma is all right. And a squad as well for a howitzer shot. That's fair enough. Now the Greyhounds come in and they're like, but they don't kill fast enough. I mean, their effectiveness against infantry, as we'll see, is 1+3 with that gunner on the top. So the gunner is like the guy that does it all, and he dies way too much. A ranger squad. We're about to lose a ranger squad. No! No! Oh, the King Tiger! Yes! And a sticky grenade goes off on the King Tiger. Will it damage its engine with 40 kills right now? Whoa! And a vehicle kill as well, but that's not important, because 40 kills. A bar has been dropped outside of this house. Who drops a bar outside their house? I don't know. The phase-enhanced Greyhounds warping inside of each other. They're going to deal considerable amounts of damage. Double the amount of damage as one Greyhound. It's mathematical. Yay. We like maths. And if they pulled away now, they could probably get the bunker if they focused it, but... it's not looking too good. I don't know why he's continuing to stay here under fire of the AT gun and the Panzer Shreks. Bearing in mind that you can't fire through this bunker, so staying on the opposite side of it will have worked. In any case, on the right-hand side, the King Tiger looks like... again, it's doing a mighty fine job of being a nuisance. It just doesn't die! Why will it not die? Please die. Just go away. Let me sleep. Have happy time. Sticky grenade on the puma. Trying to drive away the puma. This one's reversing into the blob. That's not too good. If you see the flash, it's already too late, but not in the case of a sticky grenade. A greyhound managed to just make it out alive. It goes to find some engineers to go repair it. No longer engineers there, fine. And we have an M10 out as well, so I think this entire game is going to rest upon this M10 and what did we... Are we reinforcing? Okay, that's where all the monies went right now. Well... 55 minutes in. And these players are going to take the biggest break, and they're going to be back at each other's throats, and this is the battle which decides it. So, guys, as we scroll across the battlefield, place bets now! Who's it going to be? Pepsi, Bravo, Pepsi, Bravo, Pepsi, Bravo. Who wins? You actually do not decide. Decide. Annunciator. We're going to annunciate those words, Anukio. Yes, we are. Our rifleman squad with a Panzer Trekker. I mean, they're poking in. They want to find out what's going on there. And they're going to find out that there is an MG42 there, suppressing the crackers out of them. And our own 30 cal and our other rifleman squad being hit by Neville. So, not a very good start to the early engagements for Pepsi Live. I say early engagements, I mean early engagements of this final battle. This is it. The final battle has started. And now, Pepsi comes in at an angle with his rifleman squads. I can see suppression here from that MG. We should have saw that coming from the scout squad from before. Howitzer strike comes down, but it's too late. We have to retreat here. So what other squad pieces do we have? No. Our M10 is going down. That is the piece we need to save. And that is the piece which didn't get saved. The enemy is down to 100. Capturing on the left-hand side, but that's not very interesting. We have something in the level. Our Greyhound. Our Greyhound indeed. Where did the King Tiger go, by the way? It must be over there. You can see it all the way in the back. Greyhound just going to make it out of there alive, not do too much damage. With 17 kills, I've never seen a Greyhound with this many kills. And it's going for the Volk squad. I think that's a good choice. They are capturing under fire. There we go. We stop it. Panzerfaust incoming. Those side skirts, though, will protect it. Panzerfaust team. A Panzerschreck, rather, on the rifleman. They are backing out. I think we see the 30 kill has been dropped. Here comes the three Pumas now. 6 kills. 2 kills. 30 kills. So he really likes his Pumas. Oh, no. We lost another rifleman squad. We are now down to 3. Bet free rifleman squads. Well, that's gotta suck, but we have a 4th rifleman squad, so we still have our 4th. A standard amount of riflemen. That's okay, the grenade being thrown where the grenadiers were not going to be. That was where they were. We missed that entirely. I think we do have suppressive fire, though, on the bars. Incoming grenade, though. This could wipe out that squad! Wow! There we go. And the King Tiger seems to have a fault with his engine. I saw some flickering back there, but here he comes back with 50 kills and a vehicle kill. What does it want to do, though? Meanwhile, the battle occurs on the left-hand side with the triple Pumas versus the double vet-free riflemen. You can see the riflemen are taking as much cover as possible, but it's not going to help them. We need a vehicle to actually kill these, and here comes the Greyhound to try and do that. I think they will manage to get this Puma. And if we can block another Puma, we can get that too. Maybe some stickies as well. Come on, stickies. Oh, look at the range of that. Sweet. Okay, vet free Greyhound. Out of control for the Puma. Going straight into the concrete left from one of the bunkers, the debris from earlier. And I think we can actually get all three Bravo, what happened here? This was an amazing turn of events for this Greyhound. Superb, but it's going to end here as the Greyhound gets slowed and hit right into the back. Ah, our MG42 turns round. Ah, Oh, my stomach! Again! No, wait, I'm just hungry. I'm really, really hungry. I know a lot of you will be saying, Inuki, why are you so hungry? I have like one meal a day. Give me a break. One meal a day is all I can afford. Because I bought sort of such a good computer, which gets hard capped by the software. Ah, damn it. Damn it. Don't mind all to hell. We have a bar here which could have been picked up, but these guys with 37 kills. Wow, go Rifleman Squad for Pepsi. I mean, say what you want about any of these players, but they have done a lot of attrition. Early on in the game, they got like completely wiped out. A load of guys, a load of squads, just annihilated. So much extinction. But they've kept a lot of these new squads alive. And done pretty well. We just hit the 1 hour mark, by the way. And I'm loving this close quarters mortars. I'm not sure how effective it's going to be, though. The King Tiger should just look at that and point at it and say, off with its head. Slice it off completely. It can certainly do that. Grenades. Yes, this is the kind of grenades we need late game, Pepsi. We want to be wiping out those squads. Unfortunately, the rifleman at the bar... The Volk squad with the bar got away. Damn it all the hell. We've got another M10 back here. Sweet, where is that Puma? We've got loads of munitions which could be salvaged, by the way, Bravo. Just all over the map. And bars as well, more bars. Oh, we are really low on infantry though. For Pepsi, remember he has to keep manpower so he's able to reinforce his squads, which he has on the field already. And that was a wonderful, delightful engagement. 50 victory points to Pepsi, 56 victory points to Bravo, the newcomer to Inuki TV, unless it's a Smurf account, in which case, screw that guy for not playing on his real account. Not literally, but, you know, I like to know who is who. Like to keep the standard name. You'll always see me as Inuki. I don't know if there's many Inuki clones out there. But I just go by the name Inuki. There seems to be a fair amount of people which use my name.
Stand firm, ally.
But they're usually not active, so it's okay. Our Puma is boxing itself in. Why are you doing that? I don't think it's... No, that's the bad way to retreat. He might be able to get out of that gap there, but will he be able to get out alive? Here comes the close mortar team squad. I think the mortar team could finish them off. If only they were going to set down. No, they're not. They're going to actually capture this point, because what else is a mortar team good for? And I believe they were being focused by the bar on that Volk squad. In the meantime, these MG42 squads are really hurting Pepsi. And Bravo even uses prop war to make sure his MG squad can get out of there alive. Our Greyhound is up way too close to this Panzer Shrek team. And he's going to be taking some shy shots now. Oh, I hate myself when it gets this late in the game. I can't pronounce 8 words for shit. I need phlegm, guys. Inject phlegm into my mouth. And I can continue to pursue this career of commentatory. Ooh. Bravo, though, is going to continue moving into this zone and even capture this victory point. It looks like he's going to even be able to capture this. And I think that might be game for Pepsi if that happens. He needs to get back out in the field, and most of his squads have been destroyed or on retreat. There is not enough time for this to happen. He does have a howitzer strike coming down, and it's going to be over there. Right, there it is. So he has managed to delay that, but there is one victory point in the hands of Bravo. 0 victory points for Pepsi, which means here is prop war. Pepsi, scatter, there goes a Puma, Rangers with Vet3 and Thompson's, 32 kills, 39 kills on that Ranger squad, 0 kills for the close quarter team mortar squad, M10 comes charading around, what's it gonna do though? What's it gonna do? It's gonna take out the MG42 squad. I don't know why it would... I mean, the King Tiger's over there. Okay. No, it isn't. That's not the King Tiger. The King Tiger. Where have you? It's so fast, King Tiger. Stop it. 56 kills. It's only got a few kills since the last time we saw it. And, our Ranger squad. I don't think the Ranger squad's going to get out alive. No, don't lose the Ranger squad. It's way too late. Retreat way before you need to. Here comes the Grenadier squad with 10 kills on an intercept course. Focus, focus, focus! Mortar, friendly firing! This is cringeworthy! Again, propaganda war here! Could end the game! Rifleman squads are trying their best to take out this King Tiger. M10 is doing its best to avoid whatever. It was its best. I didn't say it was good, I said it was its best. Just not good enough. A rifleman moving up in a cluster again, trying to seize control of whatever victory point they can get. Funnily enough though, Pepsi doesn't seem to have learned his lesson. It's painful to watch, but propaganda war is not being used, so it's okay. Again, we are back to 1-1. 20 points, 227 in favor of Bravo. Oh my god. Rangers are ready. Too damn right, the Rangers better be ready. Prop war again. We are just using this wherever we can to delay the capturing. It doesn't make a difference to us. We have the forces to delay them. Let's be even more irritating and delay them with prop war. We have a 30 cal squad guarding this victory point, but it's not a problem. We have optional flanking opportunities. Our rifleman squad moving up forward. I don't know why they should go for the victory point. For the victory point. There we go. Pepsi, he's got it. He's nailed it. He's clicked. His brain is working. Fully functioning brain. Unlike mine. Our Pumas, though, here they come. Now, we're going to have to use armor-penetrating rounds on this 30 cal. We better use it on the AT gun. That'll be even better. Now, will they be able to capture it before they die? No. Because the game is over. Pepsi has lost. Pepsi, man, was that a fine game. And Bravo, the newcomer to Inuki TV. We love you, man. That is the definition of excitement. The Puma aggressive play at the start is the definition of excrement, however. You guys have a nice time. I wish you all the best, and to you viewers as well. Please bear in mind that my time is minimal now, and I shall be seeing you in the future. Hopefully we'll get a load of company here as games out. Just live versions though, no multicam, so I can just get them out very quickly. But kisses, I'm Inuki to da fuki aru.
You want more video? Over there at the top of the screen are relevant videos. And some other videos below them. You can subscribe by clicking the subscribe button too. If you got this far, maybe you should press like. No one sticks around for this long. Your loyalty shall go unrewarded.